we begin to look at this topic in our life, there's no doubt that it can teach us memories of our own life. We start to maybe go back to how we have lived our life. As we start to think about how we want to be remembered. And I recall a story of a woman in critical care unit, and I shared this with you in my first sermon here. She was obviously at the end of her life, and was a young chaplain and going through CPE with the clinical pastor education. And I got to chatting with her a little bit, and she was about to leave, and she grabbed my jacket, and she said, "Do you know the secret to life is?" It is important that she distilled her life down. What's supposed to happen for us is that we think of what is the summary of the meaning of the principle, and it gets to stuff like it's really about life. And we want to find someone to pass this along to. And then we can start doing that own reflective work ourselves. So, as we think about planning our service, what is it that we come to? What is the truth about life that we want to pass that along? Maybe even writing something to a family member now. You know, as I get to this point in my life today, here as I distill down all the memories, all the living that I've done, I want to pass along to you just a couple of tweets. Rather than having the past or not having the opportunity to do that. Certainly, this raises issues that really could maybe be one of the two camps for us to look into our past. Issues of forgiveness that we need to deal with, but also issues of gratitude. Because we need to be thankful for the rest of our whole life. I just want to mention that, speak that into this evening. If we reflect on our life and our own memories, give way to the past about how we want to be remembered going forward. What legacy do we want to live? Do we want to leave? I think the word legacy is a really powerful word when we think about planning a memorial service. I remember a young woman who was dying of breast cancer, and she had two young children who would not be able to remember her. She had a 3- or 4-year-old. And she made a videotape for them and talked about her life so that they would have something to remember her by. And she talked about her hope for her children. This is important for her to do, as much as it was important for her children also to see. So think about when we think about legacy, what do you want to be remembered for? How do you want to share this with those that are important for our families and our lives? When we meet with families to plan a service, I often ask them, what kind of characteristics do you remember about your mom or your dad? And if you ever hear a eulogy, it's rarely about the accomplishments of the person, and it's often that the eulogy starts to speak to the heart of the person, and that we're all in a position to work on our hearts as well. And so I want to, you know, when I think about the characteristics, that's going to be what I speak to you about, because you should resurrect really their image, their presence before me. Tonight, I'd like you just to take a minute. I'll give you about 4 minutes. I want you to write down 8 characteristics right now that you want to be remembered for. Grab a piece of paper or a piece of paper and write down 8 characteristics that you want to be remembered for. It's a random number, and there's more than 5 and less than 10. So, Okay, any comments about how this was for you? Not what you wrote down, but was it easy, difficult? Difficult is start okay and start to play. All right, great, good. Exploding something, right? Yeah. I want to give you some homework when you leave this workshop. I want you to write your own obituary. I want you to get that information together for your family members. I want you to go talk to them. I want you to write it out as if it was going to be read in the newspaper. You can read a couple in the newspaper for tomorrow, though. And then I want you to read it. I want you to sit with that and say, what does it feel like to read my own obituary? It is something. It's definitely powerful. It's a source of meditation, not as any predictor, anything that's done in the future, but source of meditation. Stephen Covey, in his book, Seven Habits of Highly Effective People, one of those habits is begin with the end in mind. And he actually uses this practice as a way to do this. Certainly, this is the ultimate exercise. And the question is really, how do I want to be remembered? And that's a powerful question for how we live today. And as Susan read in what I was going to talk about, playing a memorial service certainly affects our families that, but it's really about how I live with now. And that's why this is so important for us to do, because it changes our focus and our intention and everything else, because we have the opportunity to make a difference today, knowing what is going to be, we're going to face in the future.